नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, Sri Mahans, Mahans, Tanedar, Kotaris, owners of Sarvangya Peetha, and everyone who is sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV and two-way video conferencing having Nayana Deeksha, I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today, 9th day of Venkateshwara Brahmotsava, Venkateshwara Srinivasa is gracing all of us on Swarna Gajavagana, the golden elephant vehicle. Before proceeding into the satsang, I also wanted to offer my respects and humble pranams to Paramapujya Sri Dayananda Saraswati Swamiji. He entered into Mahasamadhi yesterday night. Yesterday night he left the body. It's a great loss for Hinduism. He worked tirelessly to revive Sanatana Hindu Dharma, not only as an authentic teacher of Brahma Vidya, very responsible Hindu social leader, very responsible Hindu sannyasi, one of the most powerful Hindu guru. He voluntarily decided to enter into Mahasamadhi and left the body yesterday night. Me personally and on behalf of the whole Nityananda Sangha, I offer my humble respects at his feet. He will continue to be available to guide everyone. I'll enter into Isavasya Upanishad, 13th verse. Please chant along with me. Anya devahu sambhavat अन्यदा हुरसंभवात् इति शुश्रुमधीराणां ये नस्तत् विचचक्षीरे। प्लीज रिपीट अलांग विथ मी। अन्यदेवाहु संभवात् अन्यदा हुरसंभवात् इति शुश्रुम धीराणां येनस्तत् विचचक्षिरे। अन्यदेवाहु संभवात् अन्यता हुरसंभवात् इति शुश्रुम धीराणां येनस्तत् विचचक्षिरे। The translation goes, it is said that from the worship of the imperishable consciousness, the cause of manifestation, sambhavat, certainly a different result is attained. And it is said that from the worship of the manifested perishable entities, asambhavat, such gods, spirits, ancestors, a very different result is attained. Thus we have heard the revelation from those wise beings who explained that absolute principle to us. I'll repeat once more. It is said that from the worship of the imperishable consciousness, the cause of manifestation, certainly a different result is attained. And it is said that from the worship of the manifested perishable entities, such as gods, spirits, ancestors, a very different result is attained. Thus we have heard from those wise beings who explained that absolute principle to us. Listen. What should be your goal? What needs to be worshipped? What should be the ultimate cherished object of you? That question is being analyzed and answered here. Listen. What should be the cherished goal? Please understand. Whatever you cherish as goal is only worshipped by you. Worship does not mean the few minutes you bow down or a aarti you show or a food you offer. Worship means what you constantly remember as highest possibility for you. What you constantly remember as completion of you. What you constantly remember as possibility of you. If you think money will bring fulfillment to you, money fulfills you, naturally money is worshipped by you. Even if you worship any god in any form, you are only worshipping for the sake of money. So money is only worshipped in this form. If you are worshipping Lakshmi for the sake of money, you are actually worshipping only money, not Lakshmi. Lakshmi is only, as long as she is the embodiment of money, suddenly if Lakshmi decides, I am not going to disperse money to people who call upon me, you will stop worshipping. So understand, if you are worshipping Saraswati just for knowledge, you are only worshipping knowledge. Whatever you think as the fruit of your life, whatever you think is needed for your completion, whatever you think is needed for your fulfillment, what you think as the better half of you, the other part of you, listen. In one of his teachings, Ramana Maharishi says very clearly, it is very difficult to feel the spirituality, the spiritual conscious awakening is what is required for you to feel fulfillment. Because most of us never become sensitive, sensitive enough to perceive the ultimate truth as it is. Understand, our perception always gets stuck. You think, if I am healthy, I am complete. If I am free from the problems I am going through, I am complete. If I have wealth, I am complete. If I have financial freedom, I am complete. If I have this freedom, that freedom, which comes due to this reason, that reason, I am complete. Understand, even to perceive, it is spiritual awakening. Which is needed for your completion happens after many, many, many lifetime maturity. Please understand. It takes many lifetimes to achieve maturity. It takes at least 100 life in pursuit of wealth, finally for you to realize wealth is not the better half of you. It takes at least few hundred lives of pursuit after the power and position for you to realize the power and position is not going to lead you to completion. It takes almost few thousand janmas, the hormonally inspired relationships, making or breaking, is not going to bring completion to you. I tell you, somebody asked me recently, why do you give brahmachari diksha, krama brahmachari diksha to the gurukul kids, small boys, small girls? I tell them, I am just discovering, trying to find out how many matured souls I have. Please understand, when your body gets filled with hormone, but your mind is stable, not being deviated by the pressure of the hormone to make any decision or to run behind any relationship, it means you are a matured soul. For janmas, you went behind the hormone-based relationships, hormone-inspired relationships, and you understood completion cannot be achieved by it. If you have not understood, the moment hormonal actions and reactions starts happening, you will start looking around. And I am not saying you are not supposed to look around or you are supposed to look around. It's up to you. When you start looking around, naturally I tell you, drop the Krama Brahmachari Diksha. It's very rare. After many janmas, the intelligence to handle the hormonal pressure ripes. Understands, but it ripes. If you are running behind lust, you may worship any god, but you are worshipping for the sake of lust. So that god is worshipped only for you to have the fulfillment of your lust. You only see him as the fulfillment of your lust, nothing other than that. So whatever you cherish inside your deep heart, the deep corner of your heart, as fulfillment, if you are given everything available in the planet Earth, how you will spend your next 1 week? You are worshipping that, understand? If you are given everything available on the planet Earth suddenly, how you will plan to spend your next week? That is what you are craving for. That is what you are worshipping. Upanishad talks about what you are worshipping and where it leads you in this verse. Please understand. If you are worshipping wealth, wherever you are, you will only be tortured by greed. If you are worshipping lust, wherever you are, you will only be worshipping, or you will only be torturing yourself in hell. Because lust happens out of a deep, incomplete pattern that it is not going to be given to you. Please understand. Even before it starts, it convinces you it is not going to be given to you. So how many ever forms it is given, you are only going to be looking at the side where you are not given and confirm to yourself that you have not been given. Self-destructive mechanism. Self-destructive mechanism. Understand what is it you are looking in your life? What is it you feel as the goal of your life? What is it that you strongly believe will fulfill your life? That is what you are worshipping. That is what you are worshipping. Upanishad very clearly declares, whatever you worship, you will attain that. Whatever you worship, you will attain that. Upanishad is not judging you here. It is not saying you should not be worshipping something lower, you should be only worshipping something higher. No. Upanishad is not talking about that. It's only reminding you the highest law of existence. Please understand, always the absolute teaching is not telling you what to do or what not to do, but just reminding you what is. Reminding you what is will automatically make you what you need to do. Upanishads have nothing to do with vidhi, nisheda, do's and don'ts. It has nothing to do with vidhi, nisheda, do's, don'ts. It just reminds you the ultimate truth. It just reminds you the ultimate possibility. It just reminds you what is the truth. It just reminds you whatever is ultimate. It just reminds you the reality. Look in, find out what you are worshipping. Is it power? Is it money? Is it name and fame? Or is it the enlightenment, the conscious awakening? Look in and find out what are you worshipping. Look in and realize what are you worshipping. Please understand, even if you try to look in, find out what are you worshipping, even if you look in, see what are you worshipping, even if you look in, try to feel what are you worshipping, the very looking in will evolve your perception. Understand? Evolving the perception. Evolving the perception is all this verse expects to cause in you. Evolving your perception. Evolving what you perceive about life. Evolving what you perceive as life. Evolving what you feel as life. Evolving what you experience as your fulfillment. Please understand. I wanted to remind once more, nowhere Isavasya Upanishad is ready to tell you what is right and what is wrong, but it very clearly reminds you about the truth. About the truth. I'll repeat the verse and the translation. अन्यदेवाहु संभवात् अन्यताहुर संभवात् इति सुश्रुमदीरानां येनस्तत् विचचक्षिरे. द ट्रांसलेशन, इट इज सेड दैट फ्रॉम द वर्शिप ऑफ द इंपेरिशबल कॉन्शियसनेस द कॉज ऑफ मैनिफेस्टेशन सर्टेनली अ डिफरेंट रिजल्ट इज अटेन्ड. And it is said that from the worship of the manifested, perishable entities, such gods, spirits, ancestors, a very different result is attained. Thus we have heard from those wise beings who explained that absolute principle to us. That is why I always insist on expanding the perception. Please understand. Even if you build the body with yoga, what's the use? You may live 200 years. There are monkeys living 500 years. There are tortoises living 600 years. There are trees living 1000 years. What's the use of it? The number of years you live, breathe, is not the goal of yoga or Hindu tradition. Purification of perception, expansion of perception is essence of Hindu tradition. Expansion of perception is the essence of Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Upanishads are not saying don't worship something lower, worship something higher. No, they are not saying do's and don'ts. That's a job of Smriti. Upanishads are not giving any vidhi and nisheda, do's and don'ts. It's only gently reminding you the law of existence, the law of cosmos. It is said that from the worship of the imperishable consciousness, the cause of manifestation, certainly a different result is attained. And it is that from the worship of the manifested perishable entities, a very different result is attained. Thus we have heard from those wise beings who explained that absolute principle to us. Expansion of the perception. Yoga strengthens your body. Completion expands your perception. That is why I insist on bringing completion to your perception. Bring completion to your perception. Bring completion to your perception. More and more you complete all the incompletions, the more and more your perception will expand. The perception expands with your incompletions melting down. With that, the Kundalini awakening and the enlightenment, or whatever the powers expressed because of enlightenment. Please understand, all the powers are flavors of enlightenment. All the powers are flavors of enlightenment. Awaken the conscious fulfillment. Awaken the need for conscious fulfillment in you. Awaken your larger perception about life. You will see Kundalini awakening happens. You will see life is celebrated. You will see enlightenment becomes your reality. You will see clearly. What Upanishad is trying to declare through this verse: Anyadevahu sambhavat anyatahu rasambhavat iti shushrumadhiranam enastat vichachakshire will become reality in you. It will just become reality in you. Every process I do, whether it is Shivoham process or completion process or inner awakening, every process I do is just to make this experience as reality in you, to make this as reality for you. Everything is done. Everything is done just to make this as reality in you. Anyadevahu sambhavat anyatahu rasambhavat idi shushrumadhiranam enastat vichachakshire. It is said that from the worship of the imperishable consciousness, the cause of manifestation, certainly a different result is attained. And it is said that from the worship of the manifested perishable entities, such gods, spirits, ancestors, a very different result is attained. Thus we have heard from those wise beings who explained that absolute principle to us. Make this as your experience. Make this as your reality. Make this as part of you. Make this as you. This is the nectar, the amrita. Actually, exactly this is what has happened in everyone in Kumbh Mela. Now I can see how the perception of people expanded. The perception about themselves, or perception about others, or perception, how it changed. Perception about the reality of life. Anyadeva hurasambhavat. I have seen in Kumbh Mela what people worship started changing. Their greed started losing power over them. Seeking started taking over them. Happening that can give perceptional change is Kumbh Mela. The place that can give perceptional change is Varanasi. The person who can give that perceptional change is an incarnation. If you missed Kumbh Mela, don't worry. Still Varanasi is calling you. Still an incarnation is calling you. Breaking your lower perceptions and expanding it into higher perception is breaking your karma pattern. Breaking your lower perceptions and making it into a higher perception is breaking your karma pattern. Come to Varanasi to break your karma pattern. Inner awakening expands your perception. Inner awakening is calling you. Inner awakening expands your perception. Inner awakening. Destroys all your smaller perceptions. Makes you manifest the higher perceptions. Naturally, you start cherishing, worshipping the imperishable consciousness, not the perishable entities. Imperishable consciousness, not the perishable entities. So with this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
நித்யானந்த தியானபீடம், நித்யானந்த நகர், ஆஃப் மைசூர் ரோட், பிடதி, பெங்களூரு. ஃபோன் 080-2727-9999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.